Hello everyone. So let's start our second chapter, that is relation and function. Okay, so we have just finished our chapter, that is sets. And you know why we study sets? We study sets just to clearize our problems based on relation and function. Okay, sets are directly dependent on relation and function. Okay, so we have just finished out set, and one more topic is there, that is called Cartesian product. Cartesian product. Okay, this topic is left after the discussion of chapter first, that is set, to know about relation and function. Okay, so in this video we will cover up the Cartesian product only. After that we can discuss we will discuss relation, and then a special type of relation also, that is called function. Okay, function is also a relation, but it is a special type of relation. Okay, so let's start by introductory part, that is for Cartesian product. So first of all, we will know about what is Cartesian product. Okay, so suppose we have two sets. Let A is equals to any city name, we can say like our Chhatrapur, nearby Sagar and Panna. Okay, so these cities are in set A, and set B have the number that 16, 17 and 15. Okay, so if we have to find the Cartesian product, look, first of all, product, we the in mathematics product is known as multiplication. Okay, it is known as multiplication. So using the Cartesian rule, we will just multiply all the sets, yeah, all the elements of the sets. Okay, so if we have to find the product of A and B set, okay, सो बच्चों पहले हमने क्या लिखा है, फर्स्ट वी हैव रिटन द सेट ए. ओके, सो वी विल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल राइट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स, नॉट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स, वन एलिमेंट ऑफ सेट ए, देन वी विल राइट बी 16. ओके कॉमा, सेवनटीन फिफ्टीन. ओके, सो मल्टीप्लीकेशन विथ फर्स्ट सिटी इज डन. नाउ वी विल मल्टीप्लाई विथ सेकेंड सिटी, एंड दैट इज सागर कॉमा 16, देन सागर कॉमा 17, एंड देन सागर कॉमा 15. Okay, then last city, that is Panna, 16, 17 and Panna 15. Okay, means look, whenever we have three elements in set A and three elements in set B, so total we have nine elements in Cartesian product. Okay, nine number of sets in Cartesian product. Okay, look here, first of all, like we have done the multiplication in brackets, that is if we have to multiply the x to the given number in the bracket. Okay, so we will distribute the multiplication with all the elements given in the brackets. Okay, so this is the formula that is used in the Cartesian product. Okay, but look, this is the product of A into B, but if we have to find the product of B into A, okay, so first of all we have to write the element of B only, and the first element of B is 16, then we will write the name of city. Okay, 16 Sagar 16 Panna. Then we have 17 in the same way. Okay, but you have to remember one thing, the sets, the elements given in the sets are in some order. है ना, कुछ ना कुछ ऑर्डर में तो होंगे. सो टू फाइंड द प्रोडक्ट वी डोंट हैव टू चेंज द ऑर्डर ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स. ओके, इफ इट इज छतरपुर एट इन फर्स्ट एलिमेंट एंड सेकेंड इज सागर एंड थर्ड इज पन्ना, देन वी विल यूज इन द सेम वे दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल मल्टीप्लाई विद छतरपुर देन सागर देन पन्ना. ओके, सो वी डोंट हैव टू चेंज द ऑर्डर एंड देयर फोर ओनली इट इज कॉल्ड ऑर्डर्ड पेयर ऑफ कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट. ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर बिकॉज अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट द ऑर्डर डजेंट मैटर इन सेट्स. ओके, ऑर्डर डजेंट मैटर इन सेट्स मीन्स वी कैन राइट 2, 3, 1 और ये किसके इक्वल होगा, 3, 2, 1 के, है ना, एंड इट इज ऑल्सो इक्वल्स टू 1, 2, 3. बट हेयर वॉट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू राइट और वी डोंट हैव टू चेंज द ऑर्डर दैट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन द सेट्स. ओके, नाउ लुक, लेट अस, यस, सो द रिमार्क्स आर गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 31. सो इट्स फर्स्ट रिमार्क इज टू ऑर्डर पेयर्स आर इक्वल इफ एंड ओनली इफ, है ना, सिर्फ यही कंडीशन होगी, कब, इफ एंड ओनली इफ द करस्पॉन्डिंग फर्स्ट एलिमेंट आर इक्वल एंड द सेकेंड एलिमेंट्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. मीन्स इफ बोथ द एलिमेंट्स आर इक्वल देन ओनली टू ऑर्डर पेयर्स आर इक्वल, है ना. अब यहां पर क्या होगा, लुक एट दिस एग्जाम्पल, इफ सेट ए ऑल्सो हैव छतरपुर सिटी इन दैट एंड सेट बी ऑल्सो हैव छतरपुर सिटी इन दैट. ओके, सो मीन्स वी कैन से दैट द ऑर्डर पेयर इज इक्वल. ओके, दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द एलिमेंट ऑफ बी एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द एलिमेंट ऑफ ए, दैट इज वाई इट इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ बी एंड ए. ओके, नाउ लुक एट द सेकेंड रिमार्क. सो इफ देयर आर पी एलिमेंट्स इन ए एंड क्यू एलिमेंट्स इन बी देन देयर विल बी एलिमेंट्स इन ए क्रॉस बी, दैट इज इफ एन ए is equals to P and B is equals to Q, then N A into B is equals to PQ. This I have already told you that if, look, here there are three elements and set B also have three elements. So the total number of elements in A into B will be the 9 elements. Okay? Means, look, number of elements in set A इंटू नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन सेट बी. ओके, या फिर इसी को हम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं दैट नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन बी इंटू नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन ए, दिस विल गिव अस द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट ए इंटू बी. ओके, मीन्स इफ देयर आर थ्री एलिमेंट्स इन बी एंड थ्री एलिमेंट्स इन ए, देन टोटल 9 एलिमेंट्स विल बी देयर इन ए क्रॉस बी. ओके, if a and b are non empty sets and either a or b is a infinite set, okay, means it will go up to infinity, then so is a into b, then a into b the product will also give us the infinite sets. Okay, now in the same way, if we have three elements or if we have to multiply the three elements, okay, then the product or all the elements of this product, okay, A into A into A, this is called the ordered triplet, and it is called ordered triplet only when you don't change the order of all the given sets. Okay, so let's come to the exercise 2.1. So here is the first question in which we have to find the values of X and Y, and we have to find here the value of X and Y. Okay, so what we will do, look, the equal sign is there in between both, means it is given that 3 plus 1 is equals to 5 upon 3 and y minus 2 by 3 is equals to 1 by 3. Okay, so you just need to do the LCM here. So from here you will get x plus 3 is upon 3 is equals to 5 upon 3 and 3y minus 2 upon 3 is equals to 1 by 3. Okay, if we transfer this 3 to this side, then these two will get cancelled out. So we will have the value of x as 5 minus 3 is equals to 2 and 3y minus 2 is equals to 1. This will give us 3y is equals to 1 plus 2, that is 3, and then y is equals to 3 upon 3, that is equals to 1, means we have the value of x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 1. Okay, this is the simple question. So now we will do the question based on Cartesian product. So let's do the second question. So it is given that set A has 3 elements, okay, and set B also has 3 elements, that is 3, 4 and 5. We have to find the number of elements in A product B. So NA into NB means 3 into 3, so there will be total 9 elements in A product B, okay. If G is equals to 7, 8 and H is equals to 5, 4, 2, find G into H and H into G, okay. Only this I will tell you in notebook, rest you have to do by yourself, okay. So set G has 2 elements and set H has 3 elements, so this is clear that the product will have 6 elements in that, okay. 3 into 2 is 6. So first of all, G and H, so first we have to write the element of G, then only one element of H. In the same way, G and H means, sorry, 7 and 2. Okay, then we will write the element of G, 8 and 5, 8 and 4, and last element will be 8 and 2. Okay, so this is the product of G into H. Now we have to find H into G, means first of all we have to write the element of H, okay, then G. In ordered we are going, so 5 and 8, now 4 and 7, 4 and 8, 2 and 7, and 2 and 8, okay. So you can count the elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, means the product have 6 elements, okay. And here this is the product of H and G, so first of all we will write the element of H, then we will write the element of G, okay. Yes, so this is one of the important question. In this, product is already given, okay, and we have to find the unique set, okay. So look, it is the product of A cross B, okay, A product B, then the first element will belongs to set A and the second element belongs to set B, okay, means set A have A in that, so A is already written, then B, okay. So these are the set of elements of set A, and X and Y is the element of set B, okay. So this is your answer. Now you can apply the set theory in the relation or the Cartesian product also. So here is the next question, that is question number 7. So in this question, 4 sets are given and we have to verify this relation, okay. So first of all we will talk about left hand side, that is LHS. So we have A into, now first we have to find B intersection C, okay, B intersection C. So first of all, what is B intersection C? The common element in B and C, so there is no common element in B and C, then it will be null set or phi, okay. So we have to show the relation between 1, 2 product phi, okay. So first of all, look, it have 2 elements and it has 0 elements, means their product will give us 0, means A into B intersection C gave us phi, okay. Now we will prove for RHS. So this is RHS, okay, we have to find the intersection of these two. So first of all we will write the product of A cross B. So here is the element of A is 1, 1, okay, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. In the same way, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, and 2, 4. So these are the elements of set A, and we will write not as set A, the product of A into B. Now we will find the product between A and C. So here the product between A and C will be 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5 and 2, 6. okay. Now we have to find the intersection between these two, means A cross B, intersection A cross C. So can you see the common element? Okay, here look, equality matters. Okay, in Cartesian product means 2 into 1, we cannot say 2 into 1 in a set or 2 1 is equals to 1 comma 2. Okay, so it is not equals to in the Cartesian product only. Ye dono equal honge hi nahi, 2 or 1 or 1 or 2. Okay, but in sets we have learnt about order pair doesn't matters, but here ordered pair matters most. Okay, so let us find the all the elements. So 1 5 is not there, 1 up to 4 is there. In the same way 2 up to 4 is there, not 5. So we will have no common elements, means we can say that our left hand side is equals to right hand side. Okay, so it is proved. So now rest of the question you have to do by yourself. Rest we will discuss in our live session.